So, Christopher, what are we doing?
We're moving down a little bit closer to the wrecks.
Yeah, okay.
It's a bit swelly and a bit choppy out there.
Yeah, so hopefully it'll smooth out near the wrecks.
Yeah.
It's another overcast rainy day at Tangalooma, but most of the boats have cleared out, so we should be able to get a good spot pretty close to the wrecks.
We just came to shore and I was sitting in the tender and a wave came and wet my whole ass.
So now she has a wet bum. Just brought it up a little bit, put the anchor out. We'll head on up to the resort.
Yeah.
Alright, Renee, what have we got here?
We have a deli platter, voila.
We've got some
and
wine.
And some wedges. And a nice glass of wine.
Tangalooma Resort. So Tangalooma Resort was fun. We spent what's over in for $20 a loaf?
No, it's $5 a loaf. Well, it's a resort on an island. Of course, it's going to be a bit expensive.
A six pack of beer is $33 and a carton for an average beer is $90. So
bring your beer with you.
Bring your beer with you. But pretty cool place.
Yeah.
View like that, you can't complain. There's the jetty down there where they've got some dolphins that come up and feed every night. Got the cop shop. In case Renee misbehaves. And yeah. So what we're going to do now is head back to the boat and I'm going to get ready, do a bit of an afternoon fish.
Give our friend John the leftover deli platter.
Antipasto. And yeah, see if we can catch some snapper.
That'd be nice.
Let's do it.
Can we walk on the beach here?
Nah, we'll walk up here. Let's get some coffee shops, some accommodation. That's where we had some lunch just in there. Well, not lunch, some chips, some pastos. Treatment in progress. Houses all the way up on the top of the hill up there. right?
Alright, so Chris and I have just been chatting and we've decided that tomorrow we're going to head back up to the Sunny Coast because come sort of Thursday afternoon until Sunday, there's northerly winds which are going to make it really hard for us to get back home. So we've made the decision to head back up tomorrow, which is Wednesday. And then what we'll do is anchor in the lagoon for the rest of our time off, which is until, you know, the end of the week. And then just go out each day from Mooloolaba and practice sailing. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So this afternoon we got the boat prepared, pulled the tender up on deck, secured everything. Before we go to bed, we'll get down below all secured and we'll leave early tomorrow morning to get the outgoing tide.
Alright, so we're about an hour into our sail and it's going pretty smoothly. South-southeasterly winds, which is good. We're just tacking up the coast now. How's it going?
Yeah, no, it's been a nice sail. Cruising along about 4 knots.
Yeah.
Just having a nice day. Nice and cool. Not too hot.
Moreton Bay. It's Tangalooma in the background over there. Bobbing along.
nice and calmly, so I'm going to go down below and make some sushi for lunch.
Well, what's going on?
Just bobbing.
Bobbing along. Getting pushed by the current more than the wind.
Nice and slowly. At 3.2 knots.
So how are we going, Chris?
We're cruising along very nicely. We were stuffing around a little bit coming out of Moreton Bay. We just couldn't find any wind, and as Renee said, we got some pretty big swell. But now we've got the sails set. We're just cruising home. Doing a nice, steady 6.5 knots.
Pretty
quite
good.
Comfortable ride. All's good. Got the lure out the back. Probably going a bit slow, but never know.
Got Renee sailing over here.
Cruising along nicely.
Doing a pretty good job. Got us on a bit of a land. Okay. Haven't seen any whales for a while.
After one nearly jumped on top of the boat.
Yeah, so what happened there?
Well, we were just cruising along. I was sitting there and I was just looking out. And right in front of us, a humpback whale jumped right up, spun and came back in. But we were just like, one sec. Sort of lost us, got distracted. And then it did it again. And we were like, crap, who doesn't jump on the boat? But I think that second time it saw us as well.
So we do have autopilot in here, but we're not actually using it.
No, we're practicing steering.
So we're just practicing our hand steering. A couple more hours to go and we'll just hand steer the whole way and get a good feel and see what happens. At the moment it seems to be going good. Got a nice big jib out. Cruising along nicely. Alright.
So we're nearly home. We've been going for about 7.5 hours now. It's been a nice long journey with some ups and some downs.
Yeah, no, it's been a great trip. We've seen lots of wildlife, lots of whales.
So many whales.
It's really good.
Yeah.
Nice cruise.
It's been a good opportunity for us to spend lots of time.
Wind's starting to die out a bit. And a bit of flapping, but that's alright.
But we're nearly home. I'll show you the point where we're heading.
There's the point. Home. There it is. Looks like it's raining. But we're nearly there. Maybe another hour or so and we should be anchored in the lagoon.
After a long day sailing, 7.5 hours on the water, we've finally made it back to Mooloolaba. We're anchored out in the pond. If you have a look around, you can see the big mansions everywhere, all around us. See those clouds coming in. Renee has been spending the last
ages,
long time making some, what's this one called?
Dumplings.
Got some dumplings and we got some
sushi.
Couple of little glasses of red.
But I'm starving! So let's eat!
And I made her wait so we could do a video and she wants to kill me.
Alright, let's go.